Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 2.3, Problem 1. This is problem number 1 from Section 2.3. It says state the dimensions of each matrix and state if it's a square matrix, a column matrix, or a row matrix. So we have several of these. The first one, we have 3, 0, 1 in the top row, and negative 2, 1, 0 in the second row, and that's the whole matrix. So first of all, what are the dimensions? This is a 2 by 3 matrix. You state the number of rows first, and then the number of columns. It has 2 rows and 3 columns. Now, it's not a square matrix. A square matrix has to have the same number of rows as columns. It's not a column matrix, because a column matrix has only 1 column. This has 3. And it's not a row matrix, because a row matrix has only 1 row. This has 2. So that's the first matrix. The second matrix has 1, 1 on top, then underneath another row with 4, negative 2, and underneath that a row with 0, 6. So first, what are the dimensions of this matrix? This one is a 3 by 2. Again, state the number of rows first. There are 3 rows. You put an x, which is read by, and then the number of columns, which is 2. This is a 3 by 2. Now again, is it a square matrix? No, because it does not have the same number of rows as columns. Is it a column matrix? No, because it does not have only 1 column. And is it a row matrix? No, because it does not have only 1 row. The next matrix has a row on top of 1, 3, 0, a row underneath that of negative 3, 4, 1, a row under that of negative 1, 2, and then 2 again. Now, first, what are the dimensions? This is a 3 by 3 matrix because it has 3 rows and 3 columns. Again, you need to state the number of rows first, then the columns. Now, is it a square matrix? Yes, it is, because it has the same number of rows as columns, and it makes it look square. Is it a row matrix? Does it have only 1 row? No, it does not. Is it a column matrix? No, it is not, because it has more than 1 column. The next matrix, it has a 2 on top all by itself, a negative 3 all by itself underneath that, a 0 under that all by itself, and then under that a 1 all by itself. So first, what are the dimensions? This is a 4 by 1. There are 4 rows and 1 column. So you write 4x1, which is read 4 by 1. Now, is it a square matrix? No, because it does not have the same number of rows as columns. Is it a column matrix? Yes, it is, because it has only 1 column. Is it a row matrix? No, because it has more than 1 row. The next matrix has 4, negative 1, 0, and then that's it. That's the whole matrix in 1 row. So its dimensions, first, it is a 1 by 3. Again, written 1x3, but read 1 by 3. Is it a square matrix? No, it's not, because it does not have the same number of rows as columns. It is a row matrix, though, because it has only 1 row, but not a column matrix, because it has more than 1 column. And finally, one more matrix. It's a matrix with just the single entry, 7. So first, what are the dimensions of that matrix with just the 7 in it? It is a 1 by 1. It has 1 row and 1 column. So that makes it a square matrix, a row matrix, and a column matrix. It is a square matrix because it has the same number of rows as columns, which is only 1. It's a row matrix because it has only 1 row, and it's a column matrix because it has only 1 column.